Good morning, guys. It's Friday, the day before shit's really gonna kick off. I think this weekend we're gonna see some crazy shit, especially in bigger cities like where I'm at. And if anything does go down here, I will let you guys know as soon as I know something. So I've been listening to the president's COVID-19 press briefing this morning, and if you missed it, I'm gonna tell you something. Don't freak out. Don't freak out, but you know, learn and take appropriate actions. And this is reading between the lines of what was said between Fauci, the president, and Pence, the president Pence. Sorry for the noise, guys. So they're starting to kick around the idea of mass vaccinations to protect the people from the coronavirus. This is a scary thought. You know, number one, they are kicking around names of substances, of medications that may help with this virus. But this is all in the baby stages of this. But Trump is coming out. Every other sentence is how they are combating this, and they're doing things that are unbelievable, and things are going faster than they've ever been. Where before they were talking about a vaccine being tested and being possibly available in about a year. And they're starting to kick around this idea of much sooner. So the conspiracy theorist part of my brain goes into the effect of, what if they have forced vaccinations under the pretense of public safety, public health? What are you going to do when someone comes to your door with a syringe and they said, we will vaccinate you and your family? Are you prepared against that? Because you know, there's not going to be an excuse where, oh, it's against my religion. I already got the vaccine. You know, no thanks. I'll pass. Thanks, but no thanks. I don't want it. Under the auspices and curtain of public safety, public health, would it be like eminent domain? You know, say the government wants to build a road through your property and you're not selling, well, they'll just say it's for public safety and they will just take it. In this state of an emergency in which we are at right now, declared by the president, do the powers that be have that authority under the NDAA or some other bullshit unconstitutional law that they passed? Can they come in, grab you, and force you to be inoculated under the auspices of national security, national health protection, that type of thing? Do it for the children, right? That's what they always say. Typically, when a politician speaks, I take what he or she says and I turn it 180 degrees, and that's typically the truth. That's usually what happens. Correct me if I'm wrong. So when the president, the vice president, and Dr. Fauci come out and say, we will not do mass testing or inoculations on people, it kind of makes me think that's exactly what they're planning on doing. That way they have plausible deniability. Hey, we never wanted this. You can even go back in the archives and look at, you know, what I said. I said I didn't want this, but, you know, we got to do it for public safety, for public health. This is very concerning to me. You know, does it concern you guys? Are you up on this? Did you hear something different? You know, like I said, I'm just reading between the lines of what was said, and I take what politicians say, turn it opposite, and that's usually reality. On a side note, they are talking about, and I actually think they did, close the Mexican-San Diego border, or, you know, the borders between the US in San Diego. As of right now, as far as I just heard from our local radio here in San Diego, that it's only for tourism. So if you want to go down to Rosarito and get hammered and come back, they're blocking you. But they said if you work, if you cross the border to work, or, you know, they're also allowing trucks with produce and, you know, stuff, commerce, they're allowing that. But if you're going down there, or if they're coming up here just for shopping or for tourism, they're stopping that as of today, I guess, as of right now. I hope, see, okay. This is the part that, you know, I feel like, you know, I want the best for the country. But this also affects me because I have family down there. And if I can't cross, or if they can't cross, then that affects me. That really affects me a lot. So, you know, I want people to be safe. I don't want the spread of this thing to continue. However, I want to be able to be with my family as well. So, you know, I got personal vested interest in this, but it is what it is, you know. This shit's real, this shit's happening, and it's affecting us. You know, it's crazy. So I'll cut the video here. Continue, guys. Excuse me. No, I don't have the virus. Continue to top off your preps. You know, a lot of stores are limiting how much stuff you can buy, you know, like 2 packages of meat, 2 loaves of bread, that type of thing. You know, top off your stuff every day, buy a little bit if you can. Hopefully you don't need to, but it's always good to top stuff off. But remember also, there's other people out there that are very ill prepared and they don't have anything. So, you know, think of that too. Try to be a good human being and, you know, don't wipe stores out. But, you know, at the end of the day, it's up to you to take care of you. So, do what you gotta do. All right, guys, I'm out of here. Prep and Thrive. See ya.